Johnny Sadelsky, and I'm Dr. Azulay's assistant.
And we are going to talk today about the Israeli education system. We are going to make a short introduction to this system in Israel. The future of an individual, community, or even a state lies within education. This is especially true for a small yet so complicated country like Israel, with its 2 million children. So Yoni, let's take a look at some statistics.
From the slide above, we can see that 71% of women choose to study a humanities discipline in pursuit of a higher education. A mere 21% choose to study science.
What about the Arab sector in Israel?
Well, in the Arab town of Jasser al-Zarqa, 2 minutes from Caesarea, one of the wealthiest towns in Israel, only 25% of students matriculated in 2013.
Wow, that sounds low. And what about the periphery?
Well, if we look at the town of Ofakim, for example, 45% matriculated, while in Ra'anana, 85% did so.
In Israel, there is the ultra-Orthodox sector. Are they matriculating?
Well, if we look at the ultra-Orthodox town of Beitar Elit, we'll find that a mere 15% of students matriculate.
It means that 85% does not. Whoa. So why is this? In order to better understand these scholastic gaps and what they mean, we first need to take a closer look at how the Israeli educational system works and who studied in it. First, we have to know that Israel has a compulsory educational law from 1949, which decreases the age in which every Israeli child must attend school based on registration zone. It also included the right to a free education and the sharing of costs between municipality, country, and often also the parents. The educational life cycle of a child is in 4 stages. A child starts with a kindergarten, which is mandatory in Israel from the age of 5. Then he goes to elementary school from age 6 to age 12, from grade 1 to grade 6. After elementary school, he goes to junior high school from the age of 13 until the age of 15, from grade 7 to grade 9. And then he goes to high school, which is the ages of 16 to 18, grades 10 to 12. Usually in Israel, junior high school and high school are at the same school, and often they also have the same educational team. The following slide illustrates the number of children in the system according to the age group.
Kindergarten houses 21% of the children in the system. Primary school, being a 6-year span, is home to 46%. Junior high school is 14% and high school 19%. The latter two together make up 33% of the children in the system. In a closer look, we can see that in primary school there are 274,000 students, more than in post-primary school, indicating a growth in population. On average, 75% of the children study in the Hebrew education, while 25% of the children study in the Arabic education.
Now that we have seen who the students are, let's take a closer look on the system itself. The educational system in Israel is a state system, meaning that all public schools must stick to the national curriculum and the spirit dictated by the Ministry of Education. Every year, a special topic of a national importance is studied in depth. For example, last year and this year is The Other Is Also Me, meaning that we are understanding and respecting others in our society. The ministry is accountable for curricula, supervision and school structures. The system is divided in several administrative districts of supervision: North, Central, South, and Jerusalem as a district of its own. Local municipalities are in charge of maintenance and supplies alone. They cannot interfere with the curricula aside from marginal aspects. In short, the choice a school or even a municipality has is very limited, though this type of issue the current minister is trying to change. Yoni, does having different sectors influence the system?
As you will see in the following slide, the diversity in culture is very large. First, the ministry is divided into Hebrew and Arabic education. The Hebrew education includes state, state religious, and ultra orthodox. The latter only partly subject to the ministry. 1.5 million children in the Hebrew education. The Arabic education includes Israeli Arabs, Bedouin, and Druze. There are currently just over 500,000 children who study in the Arabic education. If we take a closer look at the different sectors of the Hebrew education, among primary school, for example, we will see that both state schools are home to 71% of the students, while the ultra-Orthodox schools are home to the remaining 29%.
This divide between Hebrew and Arabic, secular and religious, symbolized only some of the variety in Israel education. One must also take into consideration geographical and social differences. While the system believes in an equal opportunity education, the reality is much more complex. Wide gaps exist between schools due to differing economic situations. This stems from the constructing budgets of each municipality. First, the amount of money each municipality chooses to invest in education, and then simply the differences between a poor municipality and a wealthy one. Economic gaps creates educational gaps. This leads to lack of specialist teachers, conditions for the educators, and of course, the numerous culture and social diversity. The same applies to parents. How much they are asked to invest and how much they are simply can invest. Added to this are the extra classes and enrichment activities or lack of them. Which children are privileged to benefit from such things? And what impact do they have on child's development and ambitions?
You also have to take into consideration the Aliyah made by Jews all around the globe. Since 1950, Israel has been home to more than 2.5 million Olim, increasing the school population dramatically. This, of course, creates an ongoing need to grow and meet new expectations and needs rather than to stabilize.
So, in this complex situation, let's turn on to young adults and understand the matriculation system in high schools. In Israel, it is important to notice that the vital key to progress in society lies within the Bagrut exams, also known as matriculation. In order to qualify for a Bagrut diploma, a student must complete the required exam with a passing mark in each one. The Bagrut exams takes place in high school during the last 3 years or 2 years of secondary education. Students take exams in two categories. One is the core state subject like Bible, Hebrew, Math, English, Literature, History and Civics. Seven subjects which contain altogether 16 points. The other thing is the major. You have to major at least one choice. It can be Physics, Math, Art, Literature. Major means 5 points. Often, students choose two majors or even three majors. The higher the quality of the level of diploma, the more options the student will have when he will apply to university.
Looking at the chart from right to left, It is evident that the percentage of matriculating students has improved over the years, though simply remained too low, with around half of the population not matriculate.
One can complete high school without matriculation, though he or she will have to complete their missing exams later on if they desire to further their education or even simply to go into a career.
Though nowadays having a diploma is simply not enough. The second priority is the quality of the diploma, taking into consideration the number of units in English, maths, and the chosen major. A quality diploma allows entrance into high-demand universities and faculties and is therefore the first step regarding access to higher education.
But this is not all. A further necessity in order to be accepted into university is to take the National Psychometric Exam, which is similar to what you have at the state as SAT. The psychometric exam takes place 5 times a year and tests students in 3 fields, English, quantity, and verbal. The higher the score, the more opportunities afforded. Many students, of course among those who can afford it, takes a very expensive preparation course.
And, unlike in the United States, volunteer activity has no impact on acceptance into university.
Following graduation from high school at the age of 18, most Israeli youths are drafted into the army. This often put a hold on their professional development and breaking the educational continuity. There are only few scenarios in which this latter statement is not true, but this presentation will not go into it. Upon release from the military, based on matriculation results and the psychometric exams, one can choose whether to apply to university, academic college, or post-secondary schools. And as mentioned above, the higher the quality of the Bagrut diploma, the more option a student has. A quality Bagrut diploma is one that consists of high level at maths and English, 5 points, alongside scientific majors. STEM disciplines are the key to diploma that will open doors. Unfortunately, the numbers are not very positive.
The amount of students studying advanced maths is dropping. In the graph, you will see that in 2006, 14% of students studied advanced mathematics, 5 units. But in 2014, this year, only 9% are doing so. And opportunities for marginal and disadvantaged societies are less. In 2012, 66% of students who majored in physics were male,
while only 34% are female.
87% of students who majored in computer sciences were from the Hebrew education,
while only 13% were from the Arab sector.
And only 5.4% of the students in one of the social periphery cities we work in studied 5 units of mathematics.
Only 5 minutes from Tel Aviv, at the heart of Israel. So, going back to the statistics presented at the start, let's think. If under half of the children in Ofakim simply matriculate, how many will further their education?
How many will develop a career?
What about a young woman from Ofakim or an Ethiopian one? What are their chances?